Hello, it's Scott Manley here, responding to a cry for help from Nerdcubed. Nerdcubed, of course, has been doing his summaries of the year, including his pile, steaming pile of poop games, which featured at number one the horrific specter of awfulness that is Galactic Hitman. The end, he said, this game is so bad it could be weaponized, and therefore the best solution for the safety of the world would be to consign all copies of this terrible piece of so-called entertainment to the heart of the sun, where they will be destroyed and hopefully lost to the universe forevermore. And so I decided to attempt to simulate this act of mercy using Kerbal Space Program, and more importantly, using realistic scale solar system, which of course has everything real size. So it wouldn't be some little Kerbal solar system. No, this would be a real size solar system with real delta Vs and everything. I built a rocket that had about, 17, 18 kilometers per second of delta V, and, unfortunately ran out of fuel before I managed to get the thing too close to the sun. In fact, as you may well know, the biggest problem with dropping stuff into the sun is the fact that we are moving around the sun at about 30 kilometers per second, and it is very hard to cancel all that delta V. We barely got to the orbit of Mercury, albeit with a rather rough and ready attempt at an orbit. So yes, more intelligent navigation is required. This is the launch vehicle. It's using a version of the Space Launch System thrusters and fuel tanks. We have these external boosters that are fueled by kerosene and liquid oxygen, which will help us get us off the pad, but in space the power of liquid hydrogen and oxygen becomes the preferred option due to its lightweight and high specific impulse. After putting the spacecraft into a stable orbit, we begin an escape burn that will bring us outwards rather than inwards towards the fiery heart of the solar system. Actually, due to some problems with the reaction control system, I had to begin my burn and then turn 180 degrees, essentially. Not a standard maneuver, but unfortunately one which is essential in a task as important as this. Anyway, the reason we are going away from the sun is because we are trying to go past the planet of Jupiter, the most massive planet, the king of the solar system. Jupiter in Roman terms and Zeus in Greek. So what we're going to try and do is perform a gravity assist, but not your standard gravity assist that will take us out to infinity faster. No, we are actually going to take a gravity assist which will cancel our orbital velocity and drop us into the sun, needing a lot less delta V than a direct route. Yes, this is the trick of astronavigation that will save the planet from the scourge that is Galactic Hitman forevermore. Of course, I need to point out that the accuracy of this maneuver is incredibly important. If we got it wrong and instead ejected it from the solar system, then who knows who could find Galactic Hitman in the future. It could literally be a Galactic Hitman that would find and then come to Earth and then attempt to kill us. Of course, then we would probably easily kill them because unlike the Galactic Hitman video game, we can see you when you're not looking at us, and we can see you if you're crouching. Anyway, the course correction is made. It does not bring us exactly into the sun. We haven't completely cancelled our orbit, but what we're going to do is make a small burn of a few hundred meters per second at perigeuve. This will accelerate our escape velocity and then paradoxically reduce our orbital velocity relative to the sun and therefore slow us down. You'll note that we're using real scale solar system and realism overhaul, which means we have to worry about propellant stability and all those other things that real life curses us with. And that's it. Our navigation is complete. Our task is performed. This thing is indeed doomed to descend into the fiery heart of the nuclear furnace at the core of our solar system, scattering the molecules and hopefully the data that constitutes this steaming pile of poop. As we drop inside the orbit of Mercury, things start heating up really, really quickly. 13 hours to go on, and I need to perform a little heat reduction maneuver here. So we turn the whole spacecraft and point it into the sun. One of the features I added was a heat shield which is designed for re-entry but includes ablator material that will ablate off and protect us from the dangers from the thermal radiation being emitted from this star that gives us sustenance but will give this probe death. Oh, except that it's run out of ablator. So much for that plan. Well, we'll see how long it lasts. 13 hours to go, 10 million kilometers from the sun, moving in at 160 kilometers per second, 170, 180, 100, and, almost 190. Things, time acceleration does appear to be causing the heat equations to mess up. 190 kilometers per second. Will we get to 200? 194, 195, 6, 7, 8, 9, 200 kilometers per second. We are the fastest spacecraft in the Kerbal universe. Oh, but we've lost all contact with it as its heat shield and antenna explode. Yep, now it is just falling in. Those radiators are doing their best. They set themselves edge on to the sun to try and emit as much radiation, as much thermal radiation as possible, but without that heat shield, I fear this will not reach the surface. 6 hours to go. 6 hours to terminal encounter. Oh, darn. It melted. Well, good thing that cloud of debris will still impact the sun. I should have probably taken more precautions and perhaps gone at night or something like that. I'm Scott Manley. Fly safe.